Well, overall, must be very pleased with that.
Yeah, certainly was, yeah. So it's great that we were sort of invited to come here to play. The facilities are fantastic, and obviously to play a Premier League team, it's always going to be tough, but we acquitted ourselves very well, looked very solid defensively, didn't concede too many chances or opportunities, and we always seem to look a threat going forward. So it was a good one for us. It builds from our good performance at Swindon on Saturday, and now we're building up for Saturday's game against Utrecht.
Understatement to say facilities are fantastic. They're outstanding, aren't they? Out of this world.
They really are, yeah. I mean, Brighton's obviously done fantastic the last few years with their stadium and their training ground, and then also getting into the Premier League. And you can see there's so many pitches here of such a high quality and a high standard. So it's sort of a privilege to come when you sort of get the chance to come to a place like this and play a game. And but most importantly, we put in a good performance, and team played well. We're sort of ticking along nicely. Let's see how it goes for a Saturday.
Two of those 25 minutes periods, you confidently bossed, and you must be pleased with that because this was a strong opposition today.
Yeah, and the most important, yes, the very strong opposition. We have a lot of players that we all know, when you see Knockarts playing and Duffy and etc. So then for our point of view is always, are we looking solid? Are we conceding too many chances? Are we conceding too many goals? And that didn't look like, it wasn't the case, especially in the first 50 minutes. And so that was number one. And then off the back of that, can you then be a threat in terms of attacking and creating chances and scoring goals? And again, we broke at pace, and Jamal and Brett in particular were a threat. And you always had the feeling that we were going to score. We didn't score in the opening 50 minutes, but we had some good flowing moves, some good football, some opportunities, some chances. And yeah, it did look like we were the team on the ascendancy, really, in terms of the scoreline. So yeah, pleasing from both aspects.
Curiously, the worst period, you take the lead.
Yeah, of course, the team changed as it went on for the last period. But then, yeah, we scored off a corner, which is something we're desperately trying to improve on this season. So we scored from a corner. I think Burgess got a good head to it. I don't know, there's Chap Connor and Brett arguing over who got the last touch. I'm not too sure. I think the last I heard, Brett was trying to claim it. So, yeah, it's good. Scored from a corner, which is a good thing. Something we need to improve on for this season. And unfortunately for us, just couldn't hold out. They scored just at the end. But overall, a lot of players there have done the chances no harm. And in terms of the Luton game, as it goes, next couple of weeks. And so let's see how we develop.
You did make 9 changes in that third period. So you changed things around quite significantly.
Yeah, and maybe a few players would be saying they're maybe playing slightly out of position. Dan Smith has played a little bit right back, but would probably say that he's an attacking player, really. Louis Dennis probably wants to play down the middle, somewhere along the line, 9 or 10, and played on the right-hand side. So there are a few players out of position. But again, the boys who came on, again, they acquitted themselves very well. With a lot of experience in that group as well, when you think Christian Burgess came on, and Danny Rose in particular, two very good players who've been playing at Portsmouth now for a number of years. So again, we were able to put on a strong side in the third period. So again, we're very pleased with how it's all gone. So
good morning all around, and now off to Bognor.
Yeah, we've got Bognor tonight. A few of the lads who played in the last period are going to start and finish that game. So again, players are desperate to get, not, you know, they want to play 90 minutes, and they're desperate with all the games. We're trying to keep everyone happy, really, with the first team side of things. And then if they don't get the games on Saturdays, then there's today, this morning, and there's Tuesday night. So there'll be a chance and opportunity for 90 minutes tonight as well.
And after Saturday, all the talking will stop, and the real stuff starts.
The real stuff starts, which is good, really, I must admit, because pre-season's great, but you know we're always looking towards that first game of the season, and it's a big game against Luton at home. So it's yeah, after Utrecht it will be Monday morning, and we can get our heads on, really, and get going. And the countdown begins to what we want to be is a very good opening performance and a win at home.